This is our third year in a very kitzurtika introduction to the major concepts of Chochmas HaEmes. We should have mentioned in the first two shiurim that if one is interested in going more into detail in these things, we have a series of shiurim on Sefer Das HaLakim that goes into much more detail than we're giving now. But this really is just to whet one's appetite and to hear the basic concepts that Chochmas HaEmes deals with.
Find it a little louder.
All right. This is just to whet one's appetite to give a kitzur of what's going on. Basically, in this year, I want to talk about the union of the Shvira and the Tikkun. Before I do, because everybody's heard, I don't know if everybody, but a lot of people have heard of something called Shvira Sakelim, breaking of the vessels, okay, in English. But what exactly does that mean, right? Well, this is a very big topic, because all of Ra, all of evil, comes from this. And the tikkun and what exactly is it for us to do? So let me explain this to you. Remember, we explained in the first year that HaKadosh Baruch Hu, in order to give to Hatava Shlema, right, as much good as we can accept, we have to work for it ourselves. Otherwise, there would be this problem of Nami de Kisufa. Now, in the first year, we gave the reason, because if you don't work for something, it doesn't mean anything to you. But the truth is that there's a much deeper concept over here going on, because you see, in terms of Ruchnius, right? In terms of Ruchnius, that Harhaka and Kiruv, meaning if you're close or you're far away, is based on Dimyon, it's based on similarity. So Kaviyochel, if we want to be closer to Hashem, Kaviyochel, we have to be more like Hashem. So like the Gemara in Saita says, that Mahu Rochum Avatu Rochum, Mahu Chanun Avatu Chanun, that just like Kaviyochel, Hashem has these Midas, so also we have to be Midas. Now Kaviyochel HaKadosh Baruch Hu is a Noisim. That's what we can say of him. That's why we always describe HaKadosh Baruch Hu in the masculine, Kaviyochel. Because Kaviyochel, the Duchur is the Chinas of the Noisim, of the giver. So therefore, Hashem is always a he. Even though, strictly speaking, Kaviyochel, there's the Chinas of the Shechina also, which is a feminine aspect also, Kaviyochel, the HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Chinas of how he's manifests himself in this world. But Tzoyf Kol Tzoyf, to be similar to Hashem, we have to also give, and we have to do. Now, in order to do, in other words, because you see, if we're just taking, then we're the exact opposite of giving, right? The Mitzvah Eliyahu in his Kutus Chesed goes to great length to explain this concept about Kaviyochel, like he says over there he explains it over there. But the thing is like this, so what HaKadosh Baruch Hu did was like this. He created the Olamos imperfect. In other words, he broke, quote unquote, the Olamos, right? These primordial Olamos, which I will explain about in a minute, in order that we should be able to fix them up. Because the old adage, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So therefore, HaKadosh Baruch Hu had to create a world which was imperfect in order that we should make the Tikkun HaOlam, literally. Now, how does this occur? Well, in order to understand this properly, we have to understand a little bit the Shoshelos of the Olamos. You see, Kaviyochel, we have the Samasoira that there are many Olamos within this Mokom Ponoi, within this vacated space that we are talking about, which was created and carved out by the Tzimtzum. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu Kaviyochel, right, that the lower you go, the more of a hester there is. Until we reach Olam Hazeh, right, at the bottom, where we are, where we come into being. But before that point, there are olamos that came through. The first of the olamos, we said, was Adam Kadmai. That's the template of the Adam, upon which the Adam is based. Kaviyochel doesn't mean a gosh mystic person, Chas V'Shalom, to say that. But it's the spiritual template upon which we are built. So based on that Adam Kadmon, now there are Oiras and Olamos which are holding on Adam Kadmon. Remember, Adam Kadmon, we explained in the previous year, is the Lachin of Kesser, the Rotzayn. So there are things that are totally on that Rotzayn. So truth, there are many Olamos. I mean, the Rav says there are higher Olamos that we don't even want to speak about. Because remember we spoke about in the previous year, about there's something called an Absak Ma and Ben, different Iluyim or expansions of Hashem's name. Well, there are Olamos that came that were built inside that Or. Now, the Rav, which is there, whenever we say the Rav, we mean the Arizal. He explains that the Olamos of Ab, of the Shem Ayin Beis, we can't even talk about; they're so high. But the Olamos of Sag, from there on, we can start talking about. So what happens is like this. There was something called the Olam of Akudim, then the Olam of Nikudim, then the Olam of Brudim. Now, this is Marumas, right? These names should be familiar to you because this is these are the Marumas in the Maisa with the sheep and Yaakov Avinu, because one of the most pelvic parshas in the Torah, and of course you can be assured that any parsha is pelvic, there must be a lot of sodis there. So therefore, it talks about that Yaakov Avinu had a dream, and in the dream he saw three types of sheep, Akudim, Nekudim, and Brudim. The first of the Olamas, which is the Olam Akudim, that's the Olam of Klal, Okud, like a Kedus Yitzchak, it's a Bechina of tied together. What happened is like this. HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants to build Kalim, because Kavyochel, if there's ore without a Kli, there can't be any Kili. Because, you see, the ore is like the Neshama of the person, but the Neshama can only manifest itself if there's a person, a Guf, there by which it can manifest itself. Because Anida Gisa, the Kli, needs to have ore, because if the Guf, right, the body of the person doesn't have any Neshama, so Mamela, you know, he's a dead person, and he can't operate. So both of these things are necessary. But the ore, which was so high, would not be able there. It wasn't possible that Kalim could be makabel this ore. So therefore, Kavyocha Hashem had to reduce the amount of ore in order that Kalim should be able to be makabel this. What happened was that first we have three olamas called the olamas of Oisim, Koytim, and Peh, which I don't want to go into in these shiurim. But the last of those olamas, the olam Peh, we call the olam Akudim, and there were 10 spheres there, but it was in one kli. It was only one kli, and it was a bechina of undifferentiation, meaning it was a bechina of rotzon, if you will. But it was an expansion of that rotzon. But tzav kol soif, there's nothing that could be megula from that. After that oilam came an oilam called the oilam nikudim. Now nikudim literally means dots, like nikudos. What happened was at that point is that Kadosh Baruch Hu built kelim, but the kelim were very small, but kavyochel. They're very small, and what happened was Hashem brought the ore into those kelim, and those kelim broke, if you will. What happened was is that we were holding an oil matzilus, where we explained in the previous year, oil matzilus, and what happened was is that the ore stayed in matzilus, but nitzoytzos, kavyochol, sparks of that ore, along with the shears hakelim, along with these broken kelim, went down, right, if you will, into Briya Yetzir and Asiya, in order to make up the olamas of Briya Yetzir and Asiya. That's called the Shvirus HaKelim. Okay, they are the reason that it wasn't Kavyochol an accident that was done. Chas v'shalom, that was done by Mechuvan. That was done in order to create Rikhoik or distance. Because remember, what is raw? May I ask you? Raw Kavyochol is distance from Hashem. It's Hester Ponim. But where there's Gili Ponim, right? Where there's no distance from Hashem Kavyochol, that is Toiv. So Hashem created something called distance. He created what we have a Matzias of raw. Now, what Hashem did at that point was is he created an oilam called oilam ha-brudim, or oilam ha-tikun, which is what we live in. What he did was is HaKadosh Baruch Hu made a kololius tikun during my separation, the 6 days of creation. And what he did was is he brought up these spheres hakelim and these tzitzus, and we did, and he reconstituted them and he remade them. Okay, the shvira was in then, and the tikkun is in ma. Just be, remember we went through these shemas before in the previous year. And what he did was this parsha of the shvira is marumis in parshas Vayishlach when it talks about the kings of Edom, and I've never mentioned seven kings of Edom, how they were melech, they reigned, and then they died, and then the eighth king though is Melech Hadar. And it doesn't mention his death, and it mentions his wife, Mahitavel. And that's the Orat Tikkun coming into Misak and these Malachim. So what Hashem did was, is right, on the first day of creation, all the way till Erev Shabbos, what he did was he made a Kol, and Shabbos for that matter, he made a Kolis Tikkun in the seven lower Midas, right, in the Chesed Ruach Tiferes Netzach Hodi Yisoyed, what we call the Vak, the Vav Kitzavos, and potentially a Malchus also. But what was, so that was, and then Adam Arishon was created. But what was left undone? What was left undone was a tikkun in the Gimel Rishonis. The tikkun in the Gimel Rishonis is the Keser, Chachma, and Bina. So this now serves as and even though Adam was Chayta and he was Yorid in Madrega from where he was, but that doesn't negate the fact that the from Chesed to Malchus was already Misakin at the time of my separations. So therefore, this is now the playing field, if you will. This is what we're brought onto the scene with this. And now it's our avoida to go, and this is the 99%, if you will, that Hashem did. And the 1% that was left undone is for us to bring in the Meichat, to bring in the Bina, the Chochmah, and the Keser. In fact, the Sfarim HaKadoshim, they bring down, the Arizal brings down something called the Zivik Chitzonis and Zivik Pnimiyah. In other words, let's say Zivik again is the chinus of Yichud Kavyachol, which is a Yichud between the Or and the Kli, which is the chinus of Tikkun. And there's something that's done mitzvah chitzonius, the Kavyachol, that's what Hashem does, Lahabul. And then there's Pnimius, which is Lahabul, what we do to make that Tikkun Olam in order to build Kalim for ourselves, because we build Kalim in order that the Or should be able to come in. Okay. Now, the thing is like this. The thing is like this. What was left undone, we call klipas. Now, remember, let me explain to you what a klipa is. Klipa literally means a husk or a shell. What the pshat in that is, there's a Moedik of Vort from the Shem Shmuel who explains this very simply. He explains that let's say you have an orange, and on that you have the peel of the orange. Now, the peel of the orange is not inherently bad. In fact, it's very good, because it's a shomer for the pri. Because if you didn't have the peel on, the fruit would get ruined. But with the peel on, it's good. But if the peel is off, let's say it sees itself as distinct from the fruit, so mamela, that's bad, because as long as it's connected with the fruit, it has a matzias and it has a toelis. Mashin king, when it's disconnected from the fruit, it has no purpose. That's the same thing with klipa. Klipa is something which is presently outside the system, but if it's reintegrated into the system, mamela, it's not klipa anymore. Okay? That's the toiv ma'oi, toiv mavis, because kaviochol, mitzad the klipa that has the ability to mitzabach the toiv. Let me explain. It's a very important concept in Yiddishkeit in general. We know that the Mishnah in Bracha says, Kishim shivarchan lo toiv, kach mavarchan lo ro. In other words, when you win the lottery, you say, toiv ha-meitiv, and when you, well, what, or we actually probably would say shachiano, but when, and when you, what's it called, you know, and on bad things, Bracha lo toiv, for instance, dynamis. Why does it say Bracha dynamis? The reason why he says this is in order to show that even though that's the higher raw, we're trying to reconnect it with toiv. And even though we might not understand it as toiv, because it's very schwer a lot of times to say things are toiv. But by attributing to the fact that it's coming from a Kadosh Baruch Hu, we're being dovek into a church and the middle of the raw goes away. Let me explain to you with another muscle. Imagine, let's say, a person with Rafael Stone has cancer. Now, what exactly is cancer? Cancer are cells in the body that act independently of the body itself. What they do is, how do you treat cancer? What they try to do is either cut it out or they try to use radiation, right, to get rid of it and kill it. But let's say you could take those cells and somehow you could reorientate them, that they should now be with the body itself and not be distinct. So there you have something raw, which is a tzabach l'toyim. In other words, like this. Let me give you another mushroom to explain this. Let's say you have somebody who is, let's say, oh, this is the way the Ramchal explains it, who, let's say, he has a goal in mind. Right, the guy, he wants to be an athlete in the Olympics. Right, so this person, he has to train 8 hours a day. Right, so if I were looking at this guy, because I don't like to move that much, I would say that he's undergoing Yisurim Gedoilim. This is totally evil. This is crazy. There's no reason for it. But then when he reaches his goal, although I don't know if it's such a worthy goal, the Olympics, but Dov Kol Sovi, he reaches his goal and he gets the gold medal, therefore it was all worth it for him. Because, and that's the same thing over here, that all of the raw that we see is a Hecha Timsor, an Amsoy, or an Ocher, right, and then soy to a tachas to get to the toiv. Now all of that raw is coming mitzad the shiras hakelim, because that's the distance from Hashem, and we have to now go and ayidei our Torah and mitzvahs, we are mila beneath these mitzvahs the shiras hakelim. In other words, that's the lashon we use. We raise them up, and what they do is once we raise them up, now Kadosh Baruch Hu can be mashpia on them, and we can make this union. In fact, Ad Kedei Kach, this is called in Chachmas Emes by two names, Man and Mad, Mayim Nukvim and Mayim Dechurim. Again, remember, the Bechinas Docher, or Zocher, Docher being Aramaic for Zocher, is a Bechina of a Hashbah that's coming in the Eilav Latata, from on high down to us. Whereas Mayim Nukvim is the Bechina of going from down here, where we are, going up. What we're trying to do is our avoidance is Elias Man. It's to bring up this Mayim Nukvim. That's our avoida. And then once we do that commensurately with our avoida, then what happens is there's a Bechina of Mad coming down, Mayim Dechurim, which is now the Shefa that's coming down from on high. The whole avoida of Mayim Nukvim, the whole avoida of the Odom is Misak and the Shir Sakim, because those are the imperfections from the Priya in order to make this Tikkun HaOlam by which Kadosh Baruch Hu can be Mashpia too. Let me explain this to you at a deeper level, because it's so important. You have to understand, the Rishash explains that there's no chesaron at all in the Or, that the Or is where the Or is. The chesaron is always in the Kli, in the Kili of that Or. In other words, the well was always there. But of course, love had to open up Hagar's eyes to see the well, but it was always there. That wasn't the Shiloh. Kaviyochel Hashem is everywhere. That's not the Shiloh. Remember, because Kaviyochel Kefi Akash Baruch Tzitzum Eini Kitchuta. But Kefi us, where we're holding, we don't recognize it as such, because Kaviyochel, we don't see Hashem. So therefore, we have to open up our hearts, literally, Tzitzum Kamash Moi, right? It sounds poetic, but it's true. We have to open up ourselves to Hashem and allow ourselves to be makabel from Hashem. And how do we do that? I did Torah and mitzvahs. That's the Torah and mitzvahs. That's the Bechina of Avodah that was given us. Because what we have to do is we make Kalim, okay? Because what it does is because we raise up those mitzvahs and broken Kalim in order to rectify these Kalim. And by rectifying these Kalim, now the Or can come in, and now this union comes up between us and the Kodesh Baruch Hu, each Bruch and Kai Yisrael can be made. And what happens is, at this point is now there's a Gili of these four, something that Kaviyochel did not exist, right, before we were Malah. Let me explain this to you at a deeper level, you know, because you have to understand in Chachmas HaEmes, there's Pashat Pshat, and then there's Amplis, and there's Amplis Shiva Amplis, and it keeps on going weiter. And what is it's a greater understanding of the concept we came before it. Kaviyochel, it's brought down the beginning of Sefer Eitz Chaim, which is one of the major works of Kabbalah from the Kitzvei Ari, that why did Hashem create the world? And so Kaviyochel, it says over there that Hashem created the world in order to be Megala himself. Right, that if a Kaviyochel, if there were no Bris, then how could he be a Rochum, how could he be a Chonon, how could he be an Erech HaPayim, how could he show Midas Havai or Midas Abnus if there was nobody to be othering over, or if there's nobody to be Kaviyochel give Rachamim on? So everybody asked a question on this, right? If this is, you're telling me this is the Bris, this is the reason for Bris HaOilam, how can this be? What Hashem needs us? Kaviyochel Chas V'Shalom. First of all, we're only talking about from Ein Sof Ulamat. That's first of all. Kaviyochel, we're never talking about the Atmos of the Ribono Shel Olam. Right, because he can't go back that far, because again, that's Lamala from our Seichel, and that's where our limit. You know, we can be hiker till there, we can look into it till there, but beyond that, we move to Chol Al Tidrish, which is too far away from you, you cannot darshan. So at that point, we can't darshan. But from the Timsum Ulamata, and a little bit in the Eitzef and Orsef Kaviyochel, right, we can talk. So therefore, we say like this, that Kaviyochel HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants to be Megala himself, and how does he Megala himself? Through us! Through us, because Kaviyochel, when we break through that simsim, when we go beyond ourselves, don't think about our yesh, because remember, when we think about ourselves, the yesh, that's Bechinas Klipa, because the Klipa is outside the system, and when we put ourselves into the system, what happens is Kaviyochel, we make a Kli, and Kaviyochel, the Or of Hashem goes in, and the Mela, we become one, Lahavul, with the Rebushim, which we were originally, but we didn't realize it. Because remember, the people in that dream, as we said in the previous year, they don't realize that they're part of that. They're part and parcel of the person that's dreaming it. But once somebody gives them the knowledge that they're part and parcel of the person, so therefore they become an expression of that person. And Kaviyochel Hashem is able to express himself through us, which is the tachlis of my inspirations. This is the hanah. You see, because they, the Mefarshim asked, because the in the beginning of it, Chaim, right, the Arizal says that it's an order for that Megalah himself. That's the reason for Bris Olam. But in Sefer HaKlolim, another part of it, Chaim, he says that the reason is in order to be made to the Brias, which we explained before in the first year, as Tachas HaBriya. But they're both correct. Because what Hatava can be greater than being Davut to a Kadosh Baruch Hu? And I don't just mean that in a frum sense, you know, to show how firm I am. But if you think about it, if a Kadosh Baruch Hu Kaviyochel is Kol Yocheles, can do anything. So whatever, so it's like having an uncle who's a billionaire, Lahavdol, so he can buy you anything he wants, although this is a billion times better than that, Lahavdol. So again, what's going on over here. What we have to do is we have to go out of what's called the Klipa, right, which is away from us, and we have to go into Kedusha. Now, I'll just explain the Kitzer, that technically there are something called Gimel Klipas of Tanaeus, and there's something called Klipas Noiga. Let me explain. In the beginning of Sefer Yecheskel, it talks about Yecheskel and this nevuah that he had. Now the thing is like this. And in that nevuah, it states that he had to break through. He had to go and break through three klipas. In fact, the what's called the lush of the pasuk is like this. He says, I beheld, I saw, and a whirlwind came from the north. Anan Gogol, a tremendous cloud, the eight smith lakachas, and with a fiery flame, the negula sovith, and there was a glow around it. And within it was something called chashmal, which I'll explain in a minute, within the fire. Okay. Now, the Kabbalah brings down that this pasuk is a remiss to the klipas, the raw, the bad midas, whatever it is, right? The nesiyon is that Yechezkel himself had to break through in order to be governed to Elikus through this nevuah. Now, notice here in the pasuk, if we were to analyze it, it mentions three things first. It says a whirlwind, and then a great cloud, and then this big fire. These are called the gimel klipas atemeis. Okay, I will explain in a minute. Then it says there was a noigalus of a glow. That's called klipas noiga. And then it says he had to break through this chashmal within the fire. And then afterwards describes what he saw when he was up there. Then he broke through. Now, the thing is like this. In terms of avodah, there are certain things. Yeah, well, before I proceed, that everything in the world has kedusha. You have to know that. Everything has kedusha. Because even a rock, right, which is has within it a nefesh ha-daimon. Because if it didn't have a speck of kedusha or some way of vakus to Hashem, even the rock now, right, it wouldn't have a mitzvah, wouldn't have an existence. Now, of course, there are certain things which are more of a occurrence, certain things which are not. Remember, like the Mechaber Mesilas Yesharim says in the beginning of Mesilas Yesharim that it's the ilui gadol for Olam Hazeh to be used through the mitzvah, because in other words, that was the medrash that all the rocks were arguing where, you know, who should be the pillow for Yaakov Avinu until they formed one rock. Because Lahavdil, in a way of speaking, all of those rocks wanted to be the pillow for the tzaddik, because the rocks because when they're used in the service of the Kodesh Baruch Hu, and the tzaddik, all of his thinking is in terms of avoid the Kodesh Baruch Hu, so all he wants is that the vakus for the lakus. So therefore there's an aliyah for all of them. Now the things like this, there are certain things that the kedusha that were so trapped that it's impossible for us to get them out at the present time. Right? And we call those things usur, right? Things that are forbidden. Like the Moshe L'chazer is usur. We're not allowed to eat it. And if one were to eat it, one would be yoyer to kedusha, right? From eating it. It would pull someone down. Now, usur literally means bound. Because the word is that the kedusha is there, but it's so tightly bound, it's not able for us to get out at the present time. Mashe'in came to something called klipas noigu, which was the fourth of the klipas. That klipa can go good or bad. In other words, I'll give you a muscle. A person wants to take a cup of coffee. Okay, before he makes the bracha, it's asalahana spenu hazeh bli bracha. He cannot drink that cup of coffee. It's gimel klipas tameis. There's no way for him to extract the kedusha from there. Once he makes the bracha on the cup of coffee, now he'll drink the cup of coffee. Now we're holding the realm of noiga, because that's what the bracha did for it. It took it out of the gimel klipas tameis and put the kedusha into noiga. Now the question is, what's he going to do now with the energy that comes from that cup of coffee? Is he going to go and speak Lashon Hara, right? So therefore, he's using that energy to go now do Nevera with, Chas V'Shalom, or is he going to go and learn Torah with that energy that the coffee gives him? And then he'll be bringing it up into Kedusha. Okay? And that is Shayach for Kedusha. There is no such thing as Klipa Gemura Be'etzim, but there is Klipa Gemura Be'erichin. Let me explain what I mean by this. The Marshal, every day has its own distinct avoida to do, and every moment, for that matter, has its own distinct avoida. In other words, we asked the question before in the Shiurim, if you daven shachars yesterday, why are you daven shachars today? Well, we're going to answer that up in Mishnah in the next year, more in detail. But the kitzur, what it is, because there's different birurim which are made every day. In fact, that's really what time is. Time is just a seder of birur, the way we can experience it. In other words, we go through time because various times have various birurim which are to be made. L'moshel, like the Mayadim, like the Yom Shabbos, right? The birurim there are bigger because we can actually experience Hashem more at that point, Kavyoch. Now, tomorrow's avoida is Klipa Gemura copy today. The reason being is because you can't do tomorrow's avoida before today. It's the same thing with everything. Ultimately, Kavyoch, everything goes back to Hashem because everything is a nitzah of the poos. Hashem doesn't push anyone away. And even Chatz Shalom, and this goes very far, and I don't want to go into more detail on this, but if you're interested, we'll discuss it more in detail in the Daf HaKim Shurim and the Eitz Chaim Shurim, this concept, because of the Tikkun HaRoh, because this is the Matthias of the Adam, and this is what he has to do. I'll just explain, because we mentioned that this union of Chashmal, this Chashmal that was mentioned in the Pasuk Be'yecheskel, this is like a protective covering which one has to break through in order to allow the Kedusha, which was in Klipas Noiga, in order to go into the Kedusha. What it does is it acts as a barrier, which only allows Kedusha in, but it doesn't allow the Tumah in. Okay? But that's not for now how exactly that works. All right. So anyways, okay, so one more thing just to mention before we finish. In terms of Tikkun of the Olamites, in terms of the Avoida, there the Rishash, Rav Shlomo Sharabi, right? It was explained there's a concept called his colorless to his conscious olamos. And I just want to mention it here in passing. What his colorless to his conscious olamos means is like this. Remember, when one is in the Bechinas Prad, when he's in the Bechinas Klipa, Mahato, what that means is he's separate from everyone else. When one is in the Bechinas Kedusha, that's Bechinas Klal. Because remember, Kaviyochol Hashem is a Klal, right? Remember, he's an Achdus Pasha. So the more Achdus there is, the closer one will be to Hashem. So what happens is like this. There are 600,000 Hashemas in every door, which again, I'll get more into the next year. In those 600, as far as Tikkun Hashemas is concerned, everyone is a nitzitz of those Hashemas, okay? Everyone has within him a bechina of his own bechina, but he has also 599,999 other nitzitzes, right, which are negated to all the other neshamas. So what happens is like this: when one does a mitzvah, what one does is one is nichalal. What he does is he gives over those 599,999 other nitzitzes to all the rest of Klal Yisrael. And everyone else in Klal Yisrael has a bechina which is shayach to that person, and that comes now to that person. That comes down to the person, and that's called nixer. So now he's tied. Now he ties together. This sounds like a weird concept when you first hear it, but if you think about it, it's really the site of Klal Yisrael Reivim Zelazeh, because we all know that the union of Klal Yisrael Reivim Zelazeh, the union of Lamashal to how you can be mighty somebody else. Let's say you had already made kiddush on Shabbos. Well, the halacha is if somebody else didn't hear kiddush, you're allowed to make kiddush again. Why is that? You already made kiddush, and the Torah says push it. I mean, what they brought down is because of din arvus, right? Like a guarantor, which is what an arv means. But what it means is that his chesaron, right? Your friend's lack is also your lack because you're connected together, right? So therefore, you can go and be mighty him, right? And through him listening to you, if he can even he did it himself. Okay, you have such a concept in halacha. Well, in terms of tikkun, that's the way it works also. Because remember I explained in the previous year that when one makes a tikkun, one makes a tikkun on the level of the prat, that's himself. One makes a tikkun on the level of the klal also. Because what one does is one makes a tikkun in the entire world, mamish, at the same time he's making a tikkun on himself, at the same time he's learning that piece of Torah, and he's growing, it's also the whole world is growing, literally, to the kamashmoy. And even though I only said the legabi yidin, but the mice is the gay legabi everyone, because the truth is everyone, everything in the world has an aliyah, mitzvah this person's kedusha. And not only that, but Gedina Torah's Chacham, Mafarish of the Rishash, he's also making tikkun in the kolit, meaning all the Torahs from Adam Rishon till now, right? Because there's now more kedusha that there should be in the world. Agav, this is the side of in the Yiratzins that when we say like Mrs. Tefillin, the Kol Taryag, Mrs. Tefillinbo. Because mitzvahs also work in terms of that. Mitzvahs are different ropes, if you will, by which you can climb up to Hashem. And those ropes are intertwined with all the other ropes. So therefore, there's a bechina of tefillin in all the other mitzvahs also. Tefillin itself has a bechina of tefillin shebetefillin. That's its own. But there's also bechinas of tefillin shebeshluch hakan, and there's tefillin shebekibud abeim, and tefillin shebe everything. And they all come together to make in order for it to manifest itself and to actualize itself. And this happens at the time when one makes the tikkun. All right, we'll stop here.